there's only one more type of molecule that we need to be able to predict aromaticity for, and that's heterocycles. So what is a heterocycle? Well, that's just going to be any ring that contains at least one hetero atom within it. Now recall what a hetero atom is. That's just going to be any non-carbon atom. That could be something like nitrogen or oxygen, but also phosphorus or sulfur. These are all very common atoms to be found within rings, and when you find that, it's called a heterocycle. Okay? Now, one of the best examples of a heterocycle that I could think of is pyridine. Pyridine was a base that we commonly used in Organic Chemistry 1, and if you guys remember, it had this basic lone pair that could be used for reactions, especially for acid-base type reactions. Well, later on in this section, we're actually going to discuss why that lone pair is basic. But for right now, we have to understand that heterocycles are going to present one extra complication to figuring out aromaticity, which is that typically a hetero atom is going to have one or more lone pairs on it. And the question is going to be, do I count that lone pair towards the pi conjugated system? So for pyridine, would I go ahead and count this lone pair towards the total sum of electrons to determine Huckel's rule, or would I ignore it? Well, it turns out that it's not a clean and simple rule. There's actually a few steps that you have to go through to figure that out. It's not just that they either donate or that they don't donate. There's situations in the middle. So let's look at what the rules are, okay? Heteroatoms can choose to donate up to one lone pair each. That means, for example, oxygen has two lone pairs, but only one of them is able to be donated into the ring. Now, why would oxygen want to donate one of its lone pairs to the ring? Let's take a look. One, the oxygen or whatever heteroatom already has to be sp3 hybridized to do this. So that means that if it was sp2 or sp hybridized, then that lone pair is definitely not getting donated. It's only getting donated if the atom was sp3 to begin with. All right? But that's not the only thing. We have a second criteria. So one, the heteroatom needs to be sp3, but two, you're only going to donate if it helps to create aromaticity, meaning that you're not going to donate a lone pair if it goes against Huckel's rule. And if you wind up getting a number of pi electrons, that makes it anti-aromatic or non-aromatic. You would only donate if it makes it aromatic, okay? So we could just go back to this example of pyridine. I've already given you some clues. Why don't you guys try to solve for question A whether you think that pyridine is an aromatic compound or not, but also predict whether you think this lone pair will donate to the ring or won't donate. Basically, should this lone pair count towards Huckel's rule or should you just ignore it? Go ahead and try to use those two rules and then I'll explain the logic behind it. It's all your turn now.